Our next question comes from Leanne X. Lara. Laura? Lara. Leanne X. Lara. Leanne X. Lara. It comes from somebody on Twitter. What are some ways to combat homesickness? So I guess I'll kick this one off. Homesickness for me was very rough. I didn't go to school super far away. I was only gone 3.5 hours north of where I grew up. However, at the time, my girlfriend and I were high school sweethearts, and we had been together for 4 years at that point. Moving 3.5 hours north while she was going to a different college was very rough. Not necessarily that I missed home so much, but I missed not being able to hang out with her every day. So,
they're getting married.
Yeah.
Getting married in a month, so that's pretty exciting. So, anybody that tells you high school sweethearts don't work out, come find me. So, that was difficult. However, with our day and age and the technology that we have with phones, FaceTime, computers, Skype, all that, it makes it a lot easier. You can schedule time to call them, check up, see how everything's doing. Not to say that you should call them every second of every day and be nagging, because one, that will drive your partner insane, and two, your minutes will just get eaten up, and that's no good for anybody. So there are ways to combat that. Also, care packages being sent by, you know, girlfriend's family, having those pop in is very nice and very rewarding to open those up. Even just a simple text to somebody is great. And being able to go back home, depends on how far you're going to college. Like I said, I was only 3.5 hours north of where I grew up, so it wasn't terribly long, but it's not something I could go back every weekend. It was just enough distance to be like, okay, if there's a long weekend, let's go home, let's see everybody. If it's a vacation, let's go home. But if it was just a weekend, it's like, all right, let's tough it out, it's fine. That hole in your heart is, it hurts, but it's okay. I got this.
And kind of going off of that, if you go to school close to home, don't go every week. Don't go home every weekend. I had a friend who did that. She was very much a homebody. She went to school 45 minutes from home. She went home sometimes during the weekdays too, definitely every weekend. And that's counterproductive, because you're trying to combat this homesickness, and that's just going home. That's not teaching you how to survive without being home, because you are going to move out someday. You have to, or your parents will get very upset. Like that guy in New York State, whose parents brought him to court. You don't want to end up like that guy. So don't go home every weekend. Take hold of that independence, and it's gonna be rough. I mean, I got homesick, I think, in like the second or third month. And that was like right in time to like come home for a long weekend, and I suddenly like missed all my friends from college, and I had like, you create this new life for yourself, and that's, I think, the strongest way to combat homesickness is going to events, making new friends, joining new clubs, getting to know people in your dorm, whether it's your roommate, your hallmates, or anything like that. It's just, it's a way to sort of help you become that more independent adult. And I don't like that word, but become that more independent adult and get used to sort of the like in-betweenness that you have of being like out of the house but still in the house.
Yeah, well, for me, didn't click, I couldn't tell. But for me, I was not homesick at all. I was one of those that was ready to go. As soon as my parents dropped me off, I ran and I didn't look back. But I mean, I'm close with my parents, but I really was so ready to be on my own. I always wanted to be independent, so that, and along with Tyler, my school was also like 3.5 hours away. It was 3.5 hours south of where I live in Maryland, and I found that actually being away from my family made us much closer, you know, because, you know, when you're a senior in high school, you've about like had it to hear with your parents, and your parents are ready for you to leave as well. So whenever I'd come home, it was a nice treat, because they're like, oh, we actually miss you. I was like, I kind of miss you too. So it's really nice. So, but just hang in there. It'll get better. It is a hard transition in so many different ways, going from high school to college. So just be patient and stick it out, because you know you'll learn ways to cope with not being home. And again, it will get better, I promise. Just give it some time.
It might also not be as bad as you think it's gonna be. Like, you might be very close with your friends and family. Yeah, it could be worse,
yeah.
too.
You could always
That's when you start looking into transferring. But we have a whole section of the site for that.
Yeah.
It might not be as bad as you think. You might be. I was super nervous going into college, and I was ready to be independent too, but I was so nervous. Like, I was the weird kid in high school. So I was like, what if I'm the weird kid here, and I don't want to be like, have no friends? And then like immediately I was like, bye mom. why are you following me?
You brought up a couple of great points. Is one, who you are in high school, I feel like kind of sticks with you all throughout, especially if you went to the same middle school, high school, mm-hmm. with that same core group of people. You kind of get a label tossed on you and it sticks. Mm-hmm. When you go to college, it's an opportunity to redefine yourself. You're really going to grow in those 4 years more than you have previously in any other education system. Those 4 years, you really define your character, your traits that you like or you don't like, and things that you agree with, you don't agree with, your moral code. Everything is kind of defined in those years. So everybody that I met in college, not to say that everybody will be, very open, very friendly. I hung out with kids that I would never have hung out with in my high school just based on what they like to do and what I like to do and ours not matching. But we found common ground on a lot of things, just being in classes, talking about different subjects, and it was great. Also with the homesickness, going back to that too, one of the best ways I found to combat that, especially freshman year, is there's gonna be a host of intramurals.
Oh, yeah.
And there'll be fairs. There'll be everything you can imagine too. There's like chess club, there's there's skydiving club, that might not be in your school. There's rock climbing, board game club.
Parkour was a big one.
Huh? Hardcore parkour.
Yeah.
So there is legitimately everything that you can imagine probably exists, and if it doesn't, you can make it your own group and then people will join it. So embed yourself into that culture, embed yourself into those clubs and activities, and one, you're gonna feel less homesick. And two, you're going to make friends a lot quicker, a lot faster, and you'll be happy. All right.